everyone, I'm Virginia, one of our campus organizers. Today, talk about the smart valve monetization. The last minute of presentation will be the question and answer part. Please write your question in the chat box. And now my pleasure to present Luca Gargani, partner on Zuora. Thank you so much and have a good webinar. Luca?
Thank you, Virginia, for the introduction. And let me introduce myself. I'm Luca Galgani. I'm a partner of Zuora, and I'm very pleased to be here to share our experience in servitization. And today we speak about manufacturing servitization. So stop selling product and starting selling services. And I have a very short presentation with me that I will share with you now. Very few slides with a lot of use cases. So let's go on the presentation. Perfect, thank you. So the title is very intuitive. So smart valve monetization from cell valves to cell services. What means? Means that a lot of company on manufacturing, included the car producer, stop selling the product and start selling the product as a service or services linked to a connected devices. And we will see this in the presentation. So I'm, as I told before, Luca Galgani, partner of Zuora. I'm in Zuora since 3 years, and I'm very focused on manufacturing and servitization, making also deal with very important companies like Pirelli and Stellantis, okay, in Italy, for example. Two words about Zuora. Zuora is the leader of subscription economy. Subscription economy means a contract of trust between clients and the company. It means that there is a continuous relationship between the company and the customer. The subscription is possible also on B2B and was starting on B2B because you remember when there was the software on-premise, okay? Now all the company has, 90% of company have software as a service approach. So, and we start, for example, with Adobe, with Salesforce. And this is very important because if you believe and you follow this this stream, you also increase the value of your company. And maybe we will see before, we will see after, sorry. And we will see this also in Zuora financial number, financial statement, because Zuora revenue are 300 million of euro, but the market value is 2 billion. So 7 times the revenue. And because of this, because Zuora is a 100% subscription company. So we have a license in fee per month and pay per use pricing model. And we have predictable revenue every year. And we have a certain forecast. And this is a very appreciated to the market, okay? You see that we have a institute and a strategy group that helps the company to increase and also to enter on this new business model, because normally there is a native company that have a subscription approach, like for example, Netflix, DAZN, Amazon, that are our customer, but not all the company are native for this. So not all the company thinking about this. And we help them to go into this new pricing model with our strategy group. And you also see the book, that our founder, Tim Suo, wrote in 2018 before the quotation on New York's Stock Exchange. And this is a bestseller in USA, and this book speak about subscription economy use cases and customer monetization recipes. For example, you will find Adobe, you will find Harley Davidson. Harley Davidson is one of another big customer of Zuora. And Zuora is also well known and really appreciate to the rater of a billing platform. Zuora is a billing platform for recurring billing born for the servitization and for self services and have recurring relationship between the company and the customer. So when you sold a valve or a machine, you have a one-time transaction with the customer or the leasing company, because maybe there is a leasing, but you have one-time transaction. With the services, you have a recurring relationship, monthly relationship, daily relationship, because there is also the pay-per-use option on the services. And not all the system, CRM, ERP, are born for this. Zuora is specifically born for servitization and service monetization. And for this reason, it's operated by the principal rating company, like, for example, you see Forrester and the other, MGI. These are our global top clients. There is not all the clients, but you will see a lot of very well-known logos around the world, and we are in all the industry. This means that servitization and service monetization is possible everywhere. Okay, for example, also the car producer like Stellantis, FCA, Ford, and other, Peugeot, launch the connected services and monetize these connected services. With Enjoy, you have the possibility to have a car as a service. So you don't sell car, you sell mobility. This is the difference. And these are the Italy top customer. You see, we are in everywhere, also in fashion with Gucci, and also in a lot of manufacturing and industrial company, like for example, Elisa, A2A, Fastweb, ENI. And so we are very proud of this. And we believe also to give value to Valve Campus Associates, helping them to thinking about this without any cost, because our strategy group is for free. So we will help us. We will help you to build your business plan and see if the business is sustainable and profitable with the servitization. The point where our founder starting is this. So he understand that we are shifting for ownership to usership. So people and company prefer the usage to the ownership, because the ownership means a lot of responsibilities, depreciation of the goods, and also not a flexible possibility to make business. Okay, with the usership, you can open and you can close the services, you can say stop the services, you can say suspend the services, you can ask for increase the power of the platform for billing, you can say decrease the power for COVID, for example, we decrease. So it's a very flexible modality to growth and to de-risk your business. Okay, imagine that you buy a lot of machine, you have a COVID, but you have by this machine with the usage, you can use the machine that you need and you suspend for good times, regarding good times, the machine that you don't use. And the second intuition that our founder thinks we have, okay, product, so ownership, usership, but product to service transformation. You will see here a lot of example of logo of a company that don't make services, don't sell services, sell product. One is Fender. Fender, everybody knows what is Fender, guitar and musical instruments. So they launch Guitar Coach, that is educational services for improve the people who buys the Fender. And also with this, they also improve the target of the customer, because Fender, the problem of Fender, also of Harley Davidson, is to have very, very old customers, so more than 50 years. And they want to go also on the under 35 years customer. And both Fender and Harley Davidson launch one, educational services, also an app. The second, a connected rider subscription. So you have an app that you have with you in your mobile phone. And when you go on the Harley Davidson, this app speak with your motorcycle and makes a lot of things from anti-theft to the prevention, okay? The prevention of problems and motor problems. So, and it is very good because people loves their motorcycle, people loves their Harley Davidson. And if you make the prevention of damage, anti-damage prevention, and also the anti-theft, and also you have also the metrics about your usage of your motor is really appreciated, and they make a lot of subscriber on this. And also Enelix launch a lot of subscription services, starting to the boiler, and also to other services, to mobility and security, but they don't sell the boiler. They give you a service. So they give you a boiler and every 4 years they change it, the manutention, the assistance, okay? And also an insurance, so a package for a fixed amount monthly, a bundle of services, and you don't buy a boiler, you buy your home in a perfect condition of degrees. So you buy the 20 degrees on your home every time, okay? We without any problem, because you have included manutention, you have included assistance, you have included insurance, and every 4 or 5 years, you have a new boiler at your home, okay? And this is the very important slide. So I want that you thinking about what kind of services, of if you are able to have a device as a service strategy. So you can sell connected services if your valve are intelligent, smart, and provide data, okay? Or you can sell your valves, your machinery, your stuff as a service, like, for example, an Elix with the boiler. And this is the two different approach, and some company makes both, for example, an Elix, of servitization on manufacturing. So device as a service, it means like the boiler of an Elix, for example, or the hardware of Salmoiraghi & Viganò, or the air motors of Rolls-Royce. The device is not sold, but offered as a service with a monthly annual recurring fee or in pays per use mode. It means that time of use, time, distance. It depends to the business model. And for this reason that we help you, that will help you with the strategy group, Zuora strategy group, to find and understand which is the appropriate modality and to test, because normally we start with a test in your business, with which product, with which pricing model. So recurring fee plus pay-per-use, or only recurring fee, or one-time fee plus recurring fee that included this, 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 and this. And if you exceed these, you pay per X, depending to your usage. There is some company that offer these devices and services all inclusive. So it means maintenance, assistance, and in some cases, for example, printing and washing. Candy is one of these. And there is also another German industry that make printing, that makes also provide also color and paper. So provide all inclusive, also the consumables. The other approach is the connected device monetization. So if you have a smart valve or a IoT stuff in your valve or in your machinery, in your machine, the data provided by the machine are monetized through a series of services that give value and useful information. For example, predictive maintenance or remotely maintenance, okay? Or the prediction of consumption. And what you sell? You sell support services with multiple levels, information services or machine operation, services that improve the productivity, services that don't stop the machine with the predictive maintenance. And these are another kind of monetization. For example, Grundfos monetize their pumps with the predictive maintenance. So they give information about the state of the pump net and also about production. This is important. So if there is a fail in the net, they go and they reduce the losing of water. They also reduce the losing of manutention and maintenance. And this is very appreciated, because water, like energy, are fundamental goods for the companies. Imagine a producer of beverage that want to have 24 hours the access to the water, okay? Or another company that use water 24 hours for his industrial process, they don't have any break on these services. And they are very able to pay money to have this information and to prevent this damage. Here we have some use case with also some example. For example, engines as a service of Rolls. So they more than 50% of their revenue, that are 11 billion, are sold in jet engine service. So the companies pay per mile. So don't pay the engine maybe with the leasing, but pay the engine per mile, per current, by the aircraft. And you see that they gain the revenue earned four times more revenue with selling engine as a service than the traditional model. So I sell you the engine, finish. With the engine as a service, they gain four times more. This is very interesting and important also for you. Car tires served with Michelin, so half a million under contract. This is good for fleet manager, because here we don't sell tire, we'll sell that your fleet is every day on the street, no problem, mobility every day, no damage, no interruption of war. You're thinking about maybe Poste Italiane or DHL or Amazon, okay? And they need to have every day the tires, okay? Otherwise they stop the car, they stop the van, and they have a damage. This is the printer, Heidelberg Dux Maschinen. They sold printer as a service with complete stuff, so also paper and color, and they earn 70% more revenue than the traditional selling industrial machine for printing. So it's like Rolls Royce. So before they're selling the machine, now they're selling the service of printing. Also ELT invent this tool as a service for customer and professional. There is 1 million of tools under contract. They increase sales 26% and profit 12%. And they invent this during the 2008 crisis, financial crisis, and now they are rolling out very good. So there is a pain moment in 2008. They test these services, so you can subscribe your tool, you pay as you use this tool, then you come back. They have some storage box near the commercial center, near the store, and like for example Amazon now, and you take off and you put your tool when you finish and you stop to spend money. And also Atlas Copco makes this with the tunnel drilling machinery. So it means that very, very industrial manufacturing company are thinking about servitization. Yeah, usage rate per cubic meter. So it's incredible. It's incredible. But for make this, it's important to have Zuora that help you in order to understand if his business model is sustainable, because now you have a traditional business model and you have some revenue. Is the new business model with servitization and provide this stuff as a service help you or cannibalize your business? This is the question. Okay, for this answer, it's good to involve Zuora. Here we have other use case, Assa Abloy. Assa Abloy stop to sell stuff and start to sell assets. So they give the possibility to have a controlled assets with a card, and you can manage this programming, the assets and the authorization on the card, you see, with the software, and they sold this software and they sold this access control to the manager, maybe of an Airbnb network or an office network like Regus, for example. And they sold this service of access and programming of these access as a software. And they sold the software and they monetize monthly these assets to the software and allowing the manager of B&B, hotel, and offices to manage the assets and control the assets. The other is Grundfos. Grundfos create a solution platform for control remotely the data of the pump services. And is a service in subscription where you have a different level of subscription. You have all information, you have a control, you also have remotely maintenance, you have predictive maintenance, depending to the level of the subscription. And this is another very powerful example of transformation because they are the world's largest pump manufacturer. Now they deliver water as a services with a software, and they are operating with this in 56 countries. And of course they start, like I told before, with Zwora making a business plan together. Then they start with an MVP, and then now they are full launch this solution. So I finish my sharing of use cases and of this opportunity. And every question is welcome.
Luca, what is the financial impact of servitization?
Thank you for this question. So the financial impact of servitization. I imagine that there is a company increased value because imagine that the company that believe on this and allow this servitization strategy are evaluated 10 times the revenue, okay, instead of normally 4 or 5 times the EBITDA. And for this reason that Assa Abloy, Grundfos, Enrix launches platform, okay? Because they want to increase their value, the financial value. But also you will increase the sales because you see, for example, Rolls-Royce. So increase the sales and the revenue 4 times. And in the other example of Husqvarna and DLT, we have a 70% of increase of sales. It's a huge increase. I believe that I answered to this first question. There is another question.
Which are the cost and the time required for this switch to servitization?
It's a really good question, this. So, which are the cost and the time to implement an MVP or a strategy about servitization? So the cost, we will fix the cost together in the business plan. And we try to have an incidence less than 1% on your revenues. And we want to generate more revenue. So yes, we have 1% incidence on revenues, but we want to increase 50% your revenue. So I believe is a good price, okay? Give back 1% to have 50%. But we will see in a business plan, which is the appropriate cost, depending also to your margin, okay? Because for example, fashion has a very high margin, but manufacturing has very small margin, and we want to that the business is sustainable. So Zwora will be your partner and will cost the right cost to sustain your business case. And for time, we are able to launch an MVP in 8 weeks, 2 months, starting from zero. Of course, when the business plan is finished. So maybe we have 1 month for business plan, then 2 months for implementation. We don't have any problem to go down in your ecosystem because we are API, REST API 100% REST API, so we have an integration through API. We are agnostic, so we easily integrate with every CRM, ERP that you have. And what to do Zuora? Zuora manage these recurring relationships. It means that manage a subscription, so when your customer subscribe and click the button, Zuora take this information and manage a subscription. So manage that the life cycle of the subscriber. If they want to upsell, Zuora ask more money. If we want to downsell, Zuora ask less money. If we want to suspend, Zuora ask zero money. And so we make the rating of the usage or the monthly fee that the customer will give you. We make the billing. So we produce an invoices, okay? With the template that you want, because it's manageable, the template of the invoices. We collect the payment, and this is very important because normally you don't collect the payment, or you collect through a bank. So you now with Zuora, you collect directly the payment with SEPA mandate or credit card. If you send maybe small services for PMI or small business, and this is very hard because normally you must integrate a payment gateway, like for example Nexi or Stripe. In Zuora is included because we have a compliance that allows to manage the data of the card and the current account. So rating, billing, collection of money, and then we give to your ERP the data of all transactions. So for accounting, you close reconciliation, payment and invoices through your ERP, but Zuora makes all the previous job. So manage the subscription, rating, and make the calculus of what the customer doing, send an invoice, collect the money, and then send to your ERP all the data that you need in order to have a reconciliation of payment. So I believe also I asked to the second question.
Thank you, Luca, for your guide presentation.
So thank you to Valve Campus for this opportunity. Thank you to the attendees for your time. I believe that we share interesting use cases, and I'm totally available for you if you want to call me or write me in order to understand if it's the case that you're thinking about a subscription strategy with the help of our strategy group that, as I told before, is for free. Thank you very much. Grazie.
I wish you all a very nice day. Bye-bye.